All right, welcome to another edition of the Students' Cookery. Today we're going to make some jalapeno poppers. You can see them right here. Got some giant jalapenos. So, pretty simple recipe. People do whatever they like to do with this kind of recipe. I saw my good friend over there, Gary, at the Food Porn Network make these. And he was having some trouble filling the jalapenos. So I figured, why not to use the Pampered Chef Easy Decorator. And we're going to fill up this here with our mixture, our filling. And then we're going to squeeze it on there. And we'll see how that goes. So to get started, we have our jalapenos. And we have our, I like Nufficelle. It's a little bit creamier. We're going to use sharp cheddar, pepper jack cheese. We're going to use our Pampered Chef 3 onion rub for seasoning. And we're going to wrap some bacon around them. And let's get started. Alright, so I'm going to use some new tools tonight. Some Pampered Chef tools here. I'll put the links in there first so you can see. So what I like to do, some people like to cut the top off there. Some people like to cut them in half. I like to make what I call a canoe. And pretty much what I do is I take this part off right here a little bit. And then I'll scoop it out. And then I'll use about half of what I have here of my jalapenos. And I'm going to put it right back into the cheese mix to give them a little kick. So pretty simple. Take a nice... want a nice flat side. There you go. So these are some nice heavyweight knives. There we go. Oh, all right. So you might have to, like this one here, you may have to trim it down a little bit. I'm going to get these done and come back to you. So I got all my jalapenos all nice and hollowed out and stuff. So now we're going to take a few of these, not too many, and we're going to just going to get a couple of them. In once I get these in, I'm going to grate our cheese. Show you how we grate the cheese with our cheese grater. And then our nice garlic press. So, let's start with these. Let's see what kind of spice level we get in our cheese mixture or our stuffing. Alright. We got that. Put those aside for now. And I have a garlic press somewhere here. So here's our handy garlic press. And all you do is you put the garlic in, squeeze. You notice that I didn't peel the garlic, right? Okay, then you're just gonna pull it out, put your next piece in. Bam. Pressed garlic. So, is that pretty cool? Oh, unless you get some of the peel in. This is dishwasher safe. We'll get thrown in the sink. Alright, here's my... Look at how that peels at. So, that's cool, right? We got that. And then we're going to put our... I got some of this... 3 onion rub. I'm going to put in. Give some nice flavor. All right. Then we're going to do our nofichelle, and we're going to get our, that's just softened, so it's been sitting out a little while. All right, so we got our sharp cheddar cheese. We're going to put it on a little thingamajig here, and we're going to grate our cheese. Well, I'm going to try to grate our cheese. Let's see. There we go. All right, so we got our, we're grating our cheese. See how this thing works. Where we get a, there we go. I did freeze the cheese for a little while before we got this, before I did it, so that it would stay a little hotter. My first time using this thing, can you tell? Alright. Let me get this cheese grated.
Right, so,
and then we're back to you. Got that rolling. I'm going to add a little bit of lemon juice. Get a little bit of flavor. Hopefully that'll also soften this up. I'm gonna go get my mixing chop, I think. Another cool tool.
I'll be back in a minute.
So I use this neat little tool. This is called the mixing chop by Pampered Chef. It made some pretty quick work of the my mixture here. And now we're going to use our Easy Accent decorator. It comes with a whole bunch of tips. And we're going to fill this thing up. And then we're going to squeeze right into our jalapenos there. Going to get this stuffed here. And once we get this stuffed up, we'll come back to you and show you already here. Kind of switch to a different tip there. The tip I was using was a little, I guess the jalapenos I put in there weren't quite diced enough. So, I had to find a tip that was a little, thicker. Got to pick a little bigger opening. So, it's pretty cool. Works pretty good. The Easy Accent Decorator, $25 or something like that. Not that bad. But I got a jalapeno stuck in it again. That's the problem. There we go. There it is. See that? You can almost do it one-handed. I think this, if it's a little softer, but I don't want to put any more liquid in this. That's not bad. Not a bad little tool, huh? So. Gonna make sure you don't get a big piece of jalapeno in there. Looking back, I got a couple started here, and I'm using my Pampered Chef bar pan, which I'll show you in a minute if you can't see it. And I use this nifty little thing right here to spray it down with some regular vegetable oil. You never want to use a regular spray oil that has chemicals in it. It'll ruin your stoneware. And once your stoneware actually gets used enough, you won't even need it at all. Because it'll be beautiful. We're gonna put these in the oven. I got it sitting at 350. I'm just gonna check quick, make sure that's a good temperature. For about 20, it says about 20 minutes, but we're gonna check, just gonna keep checking on them. I don't want it too high because I want everything to cook and I want my bacon to cook but not burn, of course. So once we get this done here, the oven's ready to go. I'm gonna put them in and we'll give you a final shot when they're all done. Might change these. Look at that, just enough. Oh, this bacon smells good. I'm gonna try to fix some of these other ones to make them look the same as these. But you guys get the point. You can do them any way you like. Some of the bigger pieces there, I'm gonna leave the way they are. Some of the longer pieces I'm gonna change. And we'll come back to you when we're all done.
All right, so there we go. Our jalapeno poppers are done. So I did 30 minutes at 350. Then I bumped it up to 400. And did another about 15, 20 minutes at 400. Bacon was a little thicker than what I thought. So there we are. They're gonna cool off, and they're awesome.